So we are solving question from GATE 2022 computer science branch, and this is a very very good question based on floating point representation. So it is very good question for exam preparation. So we will solve this question step by step. So it will be very very easy for the students to follow. So this is a very good question, and it is a one of the very very important question for any exam for computer. So it says that there are three floating point numbers A, B and C, and they are stored in three registers as per IEEE 754 single precision format. Now it says that the 32 bit contents stored in registers is given to us. So it is clear that these are as per IEEE 754 single precision format of 32 bits, and their contents are given like 0x C141234550s, RB equal to 0x421 and 00000, RC equal to 0x414 and 50s again. So now we have to find which of the following is false. A plus C equal to 0, C equal to A plus B, B equal to 3C, D equal to B minus C greater than 0. So it is obvious that we have to find the values of A and A, B and C. We have to find the decimal values of A and C, A, B and C. So if we find the decimal values of A, B and C, then this question will be very very easy to solve. So the first step is we have to see what is the format for IEEE 754 single precision. So the format for IEEE 754 in 32 bits. So there will be sign bit for 1 bit. Then there will be biased exponent for 8 bits. So the second field is of biased exponent. This is of 8 bits. And the last field is of Mantissa. So this will be of 23 bits. This is the IEEE single precision format for 32 bit content. Okay, so the sign, so the first field or the leftmost field is the sign bit. It is 1 bit. The biased exponent is of 8 bits and Mantissa is of 23 bits. So I hope you have got this. Now the decimal value is represented as 1 to the power of sine bit into 1 dot Mantissa. So whatever is the Mantissa, it will come after the dot, after the point. So 1 dot Mantissa into 2 into bias exponent minus the bias. Okay, so biased exponent minus the bias. And the bias value for IEEE single precision format for 32 bit is 127. So bias value is 127. So this is the decimal value. Now we are given that A is equal to C14 and 50s. So 50s. So first we will find the decimal value of A. So this is in hexadecimal, so we can write it like this: 1100, then for C, then 0001 for 1, then 0100 for 4, then we will have 50. So we have to write 20 zeros. So 0000 0000 0000 0000 0000 and 0000. So this is 0000. So this is C14. So it is equal. So the sign bit is equal to 1. This is the sign bit, 1 bit. Then there will be 8 bits for biased exponent. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 bit is biased exponent. Then Mantissa part is this. So sign bit is equal to 1. Then your biased exponent is, so I am writing it here, sign is equal to 1. your biased exponent is equal to, if you calculate the biased exponent here, then 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. So biased exponent is 130 and mantissa is 1.1. Mantissa is your 1.1. Okay, so because there is only one value and after this all are zero, so mantissa equal to 1.1. Or so we can find the decimal value like this. So decimal value will be equal to minus 1 into 1. So minus 1 into sine 1 into 1.1 into 2 to the power. Now biased exponent is 130 minus biased. So 127. So this is equal to minus of 1.1 into 2 to the power 3. So this is 2 to the power 3. So we have to write after 1 there will be 2 more zeros and minus. So this is equal to minus 12. So the value of A is equal to minus 12. The value of A is equal to minus 12. See, because there was the mantissa part was 1.1 into 2 to the power 3. So the decimal point will be removed and there will be 3 values. So 1, 0, 0, 1, this decimal point was removed and after 1 we had to insert 2 more zeros. So 1, 1, 0, 0. So this decimal value for A is minus 12. The decimal value for A is minus 12. Okay, now we will find the value for the decimal value for B. So the decimal value for A is minus 12. A is minus 12, or we can write it as minus 12 to the base 10. Now we have to find for B. So B is 4 to 1 and 5 zeros. B is 4 to 1 and 5 zeros. This is the IEEE format representation. So we can write it like this. 0, 1, 0, 0 for 4, then 0, 0, 1, 0 for 2, then 0, 0, 0, 1 for 1. And we have to write 20 zeros for every 0. So 1, 2, 3, 4, because this is hexadecimal form. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and again, 0, 0, 0, 0. So 4, 2, 1 and 5 zeros. So here the first bit is the sine bit. So sine bit is equal to 0. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 bits are the biased exponents. Then we have the 23 bits for the mantissa. So sine bit is equal to 0. Then your biased exponent. So 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. So biased exponent is 132. Okay, so we can find the decimal value like this. Now we have to find the decimal value. So the decimal value will be equal to minus 1 to the power 0, because sine bit is 0, and 1 dot, now 001. See, mantissa part is 001 and after this there are all 0. So I am not writing those. Into 2 into biased exponent. Biased exponent is 132 minus bias. Bias is 127. So minus 1 to the power 0 is plus. So this is a positive value. And 1.001 into 2 to the power 5. So we can write it as 1001. So this after this point there will be 5 values. So 001 and 00. Okay. So this is equal to 1, 2, 4, 16, 8 and 32. So this is equal to 36. So the decimal value for B is 36. 36 to the power of 10. 36 to the base of 10. So B is equal to positive. B is a positive number. 36 to the base of 10. Okay. So we have found out the value for B as well. Now let's find out the value for C. So we have to find now, find the C is written as 414 and 5 zeros. 414 and 5 zeros. So this can be written as, so 4 0 1 0 0, and again 4, sorry, now there is 1, so 0 0 1, 4, so 0 1 0 0. So this is your 4, this is your 1, this is your 4. Now we have to write 20 times 0. So 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0 0, then 0 0 0 0 0, then 0 0 0 0, and 0 0 0 0. So 0 and 0. Okay, so this is 4 1 4. So first bit is your sign bit, then 8 bits are biased exponent. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is your biased exponent. Then this is your mantissa. This is biased exponent, this is mantissa. So here sign bit is 0. Then your biased exponent is 16. Sorry, 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. So again biased exponent is 130. So the decimal value will be equal to, so now we have to find the decimal value for this. So decimal value will be equal to minus 1 to the power of sine. So sine value is 0, so this is a positive number, into 1 dot mantissa. So mantissa is 100. So after 1 we are not, we don't have to write 0. So because there are only zeros, into 2 to the power biased exponent. Biased exponent is 130 minus the bias. So bias is 127. So this is equal to 1.1 into 2 to the power 3. So after this point there will be 3 values. So 1100. So this is equal to plus 12. So C is equal to plus 12. We have found the decimal value for C, and C is equal to plus 12. Now you can see option A is correct. Option A is correct because A plus C equal to 0. So option, so means option A is true. Then B is equal to 3C. So B is 36, C is 12. So B is 3C. So this is also true. Then B minus C is greater than 0. So B minus C is 24. So it is greater than 0. So this is also true. Now check for option B. C is equal to A plus B. A plus B is equal to 24, but C is equal to 12. So option B is false. So it is asking which one of following is false. So obviously option B is false. So in this way we can find the value of the we can convert the floating point number into the decimal value. Okay, and this is as per the 32 bit contents. So if there are 64 bit content, then the bias value will change, and obviously the contents will also change. This was for 32 bit content. So for 32 bit the bias value is 127, and decimal value is given like minus 1 to the power s into 1 dot mantissa into 2 to the power biased exponent minus bias. So I hope this video was clear to you, and if you have any doubt you can post your comment in the comment box. So I reply to all the comments, and please share your feedback, and please like and share the video and subscribe the channel, and thank you and best of luck for exams. And again I am saying this is very very important topic, and we have solved this question step wise. So if you solve this step wise, then you will get the correct answer. Thank you and best of luck.